of all the things that they need, of course, food, medicine, shelter, but for children, play is the most healing therapy.
So this is a hard surface street ball, and if a car drives over it, it can be flattened and reinflate itself. It just plays on and on. It doesn't oxidize. It doesn't absorb the water or the dirt. It washes right off. It can withstand years of punctures and abuse and rough surfaces.
While watching television in 2006, I saw this heartbreaking, you know, gut-wrenching news story about the plight of children in Darfur.
They were playing soccer on dirt with a ball they'd made by tying trash together with twine.
I remembered that I had come across this interesting material years before. I met the people that developed it. They'd even developed things like shoes and things like that out of this material. At the moment though, in 2006, there was no financial possibility of me pursuing the research and development. Almost for 10 years now, I've been very fortunate, among other things, to have become part of the production team for the Rainforest Concert at Carnegie Hall, the Rainforest Foundation being founded by Sting and Trudy Styler, his wife. Sting really wasn't in the mood to talk about music that day. We were talking about our children. We start talking about Darfur, challenges in the world. And he mentions that some friends of his, because they know how important it is for children in war zones and refugee camps to have some place to play, they had just invested money to build a soccer pitch in Gaza.
Tim and I were chatting, and he mentioned this idea for an indestructible soccer ball, a ball that would never wear out, never go flat, never need a pump. So even on the harshest of terrain and in the worst of conditions, the ball could survive and the kids could still play.
And he just stopped and he was like, what did you say? Are you telling me that you know how to make a ball that will never go flat? I said, well, I think I know. You know. He said, well, why haven't you done that? I said, well, you know, we have another startup where our finances are tied up, and we just don't have the resources to experiment. He basically said, I have seen what children play with, and this is too important. You have to do it now, and if you will, I will pay for it.
The way it works is very simple. For every one world football purchased, a second ball is donated to the deserving youth. The goal of the One World Football Project is to distribute indestructible soccer balls wherever they're needed.
For children, play is the most healing therapy. There is no language, there is no psychosocial therapy that works like play.